Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 6.6 in the inventory model. The topic for the discussion is inventory model with the price breaks. The solution for the model, and we will be solving problem in the inventory model with the price break. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the inventory model with the price breaks. Inventory model with the price break. In the earlier models, the cost of the item is constant. The probabilistic model and the deterministic model, the cost of the item is constant, and the purchase cost depends on the number of item purchased. So when you purchase small quantity, the total cost of the purchase will be less. When you purchase larger quantity, more quantity, the cost of the purchase, total purchase, is higher. In this model, discount in price is offered in order to increase the sales. So this concept, discount in the price of the product, price of the item, you would have noticed in the common market. So there will be different types of discount offer: New Year offer, RD offer, Pongal offer. There are different types of offers to attract customer and to promote more sales. So this is price break model. So the buyer will enjoy the discount offer and optimize the purchase quantity so that the total expected cost is minimum for the customer and the sales will be more for the business people. The assumptions for the model: demand rate is fixed and the constant. So the demand rate is fixed here and it is constant. No shortages are permitted. The supply of item is instantaneous. So these are all the assumptions for the inventory model with the price break. So we have the different terminology connected with the model. So R is the demand rate, T is the time interval between the placing order, Q is the number of items per order, K1 is the purchasing cost of one unit, P is the holding cost expressed as a fraction of the total cost of the item, and C3 is the setup cost. And the total expected cost per unit time. So CQ equal to C3 into R by Q plus K1 R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 K1 into P into Q. Capital P is the holding cost and Q is the number of quantity. The cost will be optimum if first differentiation dc by dq equal to 0 and d square q by d square c by dq q square equal is greater than 0. So we will be differentiating with respect to q and equating to 0. The optimum ordering quantity qo equal to square root of 2c3r divided by k1 into p, and the optimum cost will be co equal to square root of 2c3k1pr plus K1 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. And these are all the basic parameters, basic equations to calculate different parameters. The two parameters are the QO, optimum quantity, and the CO, the optimum cost. So these two we have to remember for further solving the, further understanding the two model. So model number 9, purchase inventory model with one price break. So we give one price break, one discount for a set of purchases. So we will take the, we define the model like this. So the unit purchasing cost K1, K11 and K12, and always K12 is less than K11. So when you purchase, the Q is the quantity, optimum ordering quantity, and we fix a limit to B. B is the limiting quantity. So when the Q value is less than B and greater than 0, the cost of the item, unit purchasing cost, cost of one item is K11. So if the B value is less than or equal to Q, B value is less than or equal to Q, or Q is greater than or equal to B, Q is greater than or equal to B, then the cost of the item will be K12. So K12 is less than K11. So when the ordering quantity is less than B, the cost is higher. When the ordering quantity is greater than B, then the cost will be K12. Now, the total expected cost for Q value less than B and greater than 0. So, the same previous equation. So, this equation we have to modify for the current situation, and so modifying C1Q equal to C3 R by Q plus K11 R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 K11 into P into Q. Then optimum quantity Q1 equal to square root of 2 C3 R divided by K11 P. The optimum cost will be COQ1 equal to square root of 2 C3 K11 PR plus K11 R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. Total expected cost if Q value is greater than or equal to B. So, when the purchase quantity is greater than or equal to the limiting quantity B, then the total cost C2Q equal to C3 into R by capital R by Q plus K12 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 K12 into PQ. Now, the optimum quantity when the purchase quantity is higher, Q2 equal to square root of 2 C3 R divided by K12 into P. So, these are all the equations. So, when the purchase Q is the purchase quantity, when the purchase quantity is less than B, the optimum quantity is C1 and the optimum cost is COQ1. When the purchase quantity Q is greater than or equal to B, the optimum quantity is Q2 and optimum cost equal to C2Q. Now, the optimum cost equal to COQ2 equal to square root of 2C3 K12 PR plus K12 R divided by plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. Now, how to calculate the value? First, you calculate Q2 if B is less than Q2. So, when the purchase quantity Q2 is greater than B, then optimum size is Q2. Optimum size is Q2 and the optimum cost equal to COQ equal to COQ2. That is the solution. If B is greater than Q2, so B is greater than Q2, then calculate Q1. Calculate Q1, COQ1 and C2B. So, we have to calculate three parameters here. Q1 we have to calculate, COQ1 we have to calculate, and the cost of optimum quantity Q1 and cost for the quantity B we have to calculate. Then again, when C2B is greater than COQ1, then the optimum size is Q1 and the cost will be COQ1. When the C2B is less than COQ1, then optimum size is B and the optimum cost equal to COB. So, this is the flow chart to solve the problem. First step, you have to calculate Q2. There are two conditions. B value is less than Q2. In that case, the optimum size is Q2, then the cost will be COQ2. Optimum cost will be COQ2. Then when the B value is greater than Q2, then calculate the three parameters Q1, COQ1 and C2B. So, there again we have to compare the cost here. So, C2B is greater than COQ1, the optimum size is Q1 and the optimum cost is COQ1. When C2B is less than COQ1, then optimum size is B and the optimum cost is COB. So, to understand the solution procedure, we have some one or two numerical examples. The first example, example number 16, a company requires 200 castings per month. The requirement is assumed to be fixed and known. The setup cost per procurement is ₹350. The holding cost is 2% of the cost of the item. The price break details are below. So, K11 equal to ₹10 when the purchasing quantity is less than 500 greater than 0. The K12 equal to ₹9.5 when the purchase quantity is greater than or equal to 500. So, the solution. So, first we calculate Q2. So, Q2 the answer is square root of 2C3R divided by K12 into P. So, square root of 2 into 350 into 200 divided by 9.5 into 0.02. Which is equal to 858. So, C3 is the procurement cost. C3 is the procurement cost and the P equal to the 2% 0.02. Then Q2 equal to 858 and B equal to 500. So, B is by 500. So, Q2 is greater than B. The optimum lot size equal to Q2, which is 858. So, the optimum cost will be COQ2 equal to square root of 2C3 K12 into P into R plus K12 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. So, substituting the parameters, COQ2 equal to square root of 2 into 350 into 9.5 into 0.02 into 200. the demand rate is 200 plus 9.5 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 350 into 0.02. The cost will be, optimum cost will be rupees 2066.60. So this is the solution. So the optimum quantity Qt equal to 858 and the optimum cost is 266.6. Example number 17. Find the optimal purchase quantity for the following data. So P equal to 10%, C equal to rupees 100, R equal to 200, and the K11 equal to rupees 10 for the quantity Q is less than 3000. K12, the purchase cost, unit cost K12 equal to rupees 9.5 when the purchase quantity is greater than or equal to 3000. So we calculate again Q2. So it is square root of 2C3R divided by K12 into P. So substituting square root of 2 into 100 into 200 divided by 9.5 into 0.01 equal to 205. So Q2 equal to 205 and B equal to 3000. So Q2 is less than B. So when Q2 is less than B, we have to calculate Q1. So Q1 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K11 into P, which is 2 into 100 into 200 divided by 10 into 0.01 equal to 200. Then we have to calculate COQ1, so which is square root of 2C3K11PR plus K11R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. Substituting numerical values, square root of 2 into 100 into 10 into 0.01 into 200. K11 equal to 10, so plus 10 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 100 into 0.01, which is 2205. And C2B we have to calculate, C3 into R by B plus K12 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 K12 into P into B. So substituting numerical values, 100 into 200 divided by 3000 plus 9.5 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 100 into 0.01 plus 1 by 2 into 9.5 into 0.01 into 3000. So the cost is 3336.60. And here C2B is greater than COQ1. So the optimum size is Q1, which is 200 unit, and the optimum cost equal to COQ1, which is 2205. So we decide based on the cost of inventory. So optimum cost we have to calculate. So based on the optimum cost, we have to make a decision. And the next model, model number 10, the purchase inventory model with the two price breaks. So the model is defined like this. We are giving two types of discount. So the unit purchase cost equal to K11 when the purchase quantity is less than B1 and greater than 0. The purchasing cost will be K12 when the quantity is less than B2 and greater than or equal to B1. And the unit cost will be K13 when the purchase quantity is greater than or equal to B2. Greater than or equal to B2. Now the total cost. So when the total cost of the equation for Q is less than B1 and greater than 0, so C1Q equal to C3 into R by Q plus K11 R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 into K11 into PQ. The optimum quantity Q1 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K11 into P. The optimum cost COQ1 equal to square root of 2C3K11 into P into R plus K11 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. When the total cost of the equation, cost equation for quantity Q is less than B2 and greater than or equal to B1, then C2Q equal to C3 into R by Q plus K12 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 K12 into PQ. So the optimum quantity Q2 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K12 into P. And the optimum cost will be COQT equal to square root of 2C3K12PR plus K12R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. The total cost of the equation when Q is greater than or equal to B2, the third condition. So C3Q equal to C3 into R by Q plus K13 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 into K13 into P into Q. And the optimum quantity Q3 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K13 into P. And the optimum cost will be COQ3 equal to square root of 2C3K13PR plus K13 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. So we have to remember. So if you understand the resemblance of the equation, You remember, you look at here, K13 is replaced by K11, K12, and other terms are will be equal. Similarly, in the Q3 equation, denominator K13 is replaced by K12 and K11. That you have to remember. The logic of writing the equation you have to remember. So, to solve the problem in the inventory model with the two price breaks, first we have to calculate Q3. When Q3 is greater than B2, then optimum size equal to Q3, then the optimum cost will be COQ3. When B2 is greater than Q3, then calculate Q2. So, when Q2 is calculated, we have to compare the quantity Q2 with B2 and B1. So, Q2 is less than B2 and greater than B1. In that case, we have to calculate the two costs, COQ2 and C3B2. The optimum size correspond to the least of the two costs. So, when the cost COQ2 is less, then the optimum quantity is Q2. When C3B2 is less, then the optimum quantity will be B2. Then we have to, when the Q2 value is less than B1, then you have to calculate Q1, then the optimum cost, you have to calculate three costs, COQ1, C2B1 and C3B2, then the optimum cost depends at the minimum of the three values. So, this is the flow chart to solve the problem with the inventory model with the two price breaks. Then we take one numerical example to understand the solution procedure. Example number 18. Find the optimal order quantity for a product for which the price breaks are as follows. The quantity Q1 is less than 500, greater than 0, the price will be rupees 10, K11 equal to 10. When the Q2 value is less than 750 and greater than equal to 500, the cost will be rupees 9.25. When the Q3 third quantity is greater than 750, then the greater than equal to 750, the cost K13 equal to rupees 8.75. The monthly demand for the product is 200 unit. Cost of the storage is 2% of the unit cost, and the ordering cost is rupees 350. Then the demand rate R equal to 200, B1 equal to 500, B2 equal to 750. The cost of shortage is P equal to 2% and setup cost C3 equal to 350. So, we calculate Q3. So, Q3 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K13 P into P. Square root of 2 into 350 into 200 divided by 8.75 into 0.02 equal to 894 unit. And now here Q3 is greater than B2. So, B2 value is 750 and the Q3 value is greater than B2, which is 894 units. So, the optimum cost COQ3 equal to square root of 2C3K1P into R plus K13 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. So, substituting all the numerical values, COQ3 equal to square root of 2 into 350 into 8.75 into 0.02 into 200 plus 8.75 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 350 into 0.02, which is 1910. So, this is the optimum cost. The optimum quantity is going to be 894. Then the example number 19, find the optimal order quantity for a product for which the price breaks are given below. So, when the Q1 value is greater than 0 and less than 3000, the cost of the one unit is rupees 10. When the Q2 purchase quantity Q2 is greater than equal to 3000, less than 5000, the cost will be rupees 9.25. When the purchase quantity is greater than 5000, the cost will be rupees 850. The monthly demand for the product is 200 unit. Cost of the storage is 10% of the unit cost and the cost of ordering is rupees 100. So, we are given R equal to 200, B1 equal to 3000, B2 equal to 5000. The storage cost P equal to 10% and setup cost C3 equal to rupees 100. So, we calculate Q3, which is square root of 2C3R divided by K13 into P, which is square root of 2 into 100 into 200 divided by 8.5 into 0.01 equal to 216 units. And the Q3 is less than B2, then we calculate Q2. So, calculating Q2, which is square root of 2C3R divided by K12 into P, which is square root of 2 into 100 into 200 divided by 9.25 into 0.1, which is 207 unit. Now, Q2 is less than B1, so calculate Q1. So, Q1 equal to square root of 2C3R divided by K11P, which is square root of 2 into 100 into 200 divided by 10 into 0.1, which is 200 unit. So calculate the three costs, COQ1, C2B1 and C3B2. So calculating COQ1, which is square root of 2C3 into K11 into P into R plus K11 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P. Substituting numerical value is square root of 2 into 100 into 10 into 0.1 into 200 plus 10 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 100 into 0.1. So this is 2205. And the C2B1 equal to C3 into R by B1 plus K12 into R plus 1 by 2 into C3 into P plus 1 by 2 into K12 into P into B1. Substituting numerical value is 100 into 200 divided by 3000 plus 9.25 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 100 into 0.1 plus 1 by 2 into 9.25 into 0.1 into 3000, which is 3249.2 rupees, 3249.2. Then C3B2 equal to C3 into R by B2 plus K13 into R plus 1 by 2 C3 into P plus 1 by 2 into K13 P into B2. Substituting numerical value is 100 into 200 by 5000 plus 8.5 into 200 plus 1 by 2 into 100 into 0.1 plus 1 by 2 into 8.5 into 0.1 into 5000. So calculating rupees 3834. So among the three values, least among the values COQ1, C2B1 and C3B2, COQ1 is the minimum value. So, which is the optimum quantity is 200 and the optimum cost is 2205. So, this is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and you may find the book Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information on the subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the inventory model. Until then, bye bye.